So you're against the Nikali.
Yeah.
Shit, dude, you should have fun with this matchup. So what you're gonna do here? Right, she's gonna buy probably a Negatron if she's smart, and then she'll go into Gunblade. No, this is bad. So what you're gonna do with your itemization, if you really want to just destroy her, is divert it a little bit, and you can go, like the Forbidden Chapter for the mana, and then Sorc Shoes like is standard. Like Syndra's really like Forbidden Chapter into Sorcs, and then you can go Haunting Guise for the pen
Yeah.
if you want to be able to 100 to zero her, and then finish the Morello. Unless you destroy her by so much early that you could just finish the Morello and then crush her team on rotation, like use the Morello to just shove out every wave and then roam, then that's a scenario where you could do that. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So that's like just what you want to be thinking going into the matchup itself. And then as well as the fact that you're ranged versus melee, you don't want to auto this first minion. So if you auto this first minion, you're just kind of shoving it to her, which is what she wants. She wants to get this going towards her, but you're not utilizing your ability to punish her, you know what I mean, for each CS. So if you just hold the wave, then when she walks up, you can auto Q every time. You can proc Thunderlords on her for just any single minion that she goes for. And she knows that. That's why she didn't move up on you. But you didn't utilize that because you shoved this into her. Does that make sense?
Yeah, it was really
So,
bad.
yeah.
We should just get a lot free CS.
Yeah. You have Thunderlords, right? How come it hasn't procced? Finally. Yeah, holy
Yeah.
moly. You procced your first Thunderlords 40 seconds into the lane against the rain or a melee champion. Yeah, so you can, I guess, lean to the left here. Depending on who's their jungler, I didn't even see.
I think it was like Graves. Shall even I can't
Yeah, it was
remember.
Graves.
Yeah.
So their jungler was Graves. No, you didn't even need to. Like, you should have stayed here. So since he can't just walk around and like cheese gank you here, and he's gonna want to either full clear or go to a side lane with double buff. Because if he walks, like if he let's say level two cheeses with red through here, you literally just walk out. Like you slow one of them and walk out. Sure, he cheeses you for some HP, but Akali's not even gonna be able to do anything with it really, and he's just wasting his time and revealing himself, which is really bad for him. So your best bet is to just stand, and you can dump on her. Yeah, anytime that she tries to CS, you don't wanna even float there. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
And you still have him this low. You know what I mean? Like, you would have definitely forced him to base, and you should have, earlier on. Okay. Alright, I like that. You could have gone for another auto, though. For sure. Especially because, like, in that's actually so good because you also stun the minions, right? So even when you walk up to auto her, you don't even take the minion aggro because they're still stunned. And just walk out without taking any damage whatsoever and
Yeah.
just crushing her like that. You should shove her off the tower. She shouldn't be anywhere near this dude. Yeah. Now put that on the casters and just click, go for the wave clear because she knows that she's gonna have to base for sure. She's just making you use your cooldowns and mana on something else by baiting you there, you know what I mean? Where instead you can just be making her waste her time. All right. So she was smart in taking teleport, but she should have been forced to use it about a minute and a half earlier. You know what I mean? So, yeah. Here, I wouldn't even. No, there's no reason to go for another Doran's. Honestly, I think your best bet there is to go with how much you're punishing her anyway, and how much you could be. You should go Darkseal plus a boot. Like just tier 1 boot with Darkseal is good there with 650. Because at level 5, or 6, sorry, A level 6, if she's in the lane, 100% she's dead. Especially since she didn't get any sort of MR on her first buy. So, if I saw her buy right when you tabbed. And you're not tabbing enough, by the way. You should be up to date with like what Graves got on his first buy and what she did. I barely saw what she got. Okay, here we go. Yeah, so she didn't get any MR. So you definitely could have gone Dark Seal plus Boots 1, and then shove her in, use the movement speed to get, like, in and out of the minion aggro, and just smash her in lane. And then if you take her out of lane and you shove the wave in, you can even roam with the boots and help your jungler out.
Is Dark Seal that good on Syndra? Like, I don't think I've ever built it.
I mean, it's built a lot just for the early game buy and the potential of getting the stacks, which Syndra has a pretty guaranteed way to get stacks, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So it actually scales better than Doran's. And you don't need a Doran's to survive lane here, right? Like, if you're against someone where you really have to survive lane, that's when you'd want double Doran's. Or let's say it massively exaggerates your bully pressure, like on LeBlanc in certain metas, you know what I mean? That's when you would go, like, Doran's ring, double Doran's. But here, none of those apply. Let's see what you did there mechanically. That could have been better. Okay, Graves still isn't here, but you have control of the right side of river, so you want to stay towards the right side. And then you want to think, if he comes through here, you just want to make sure you're not here, so he can't just, like, flash QR you, and then once she turns 6, she jumps on you. So yeah, like, you can just play here and here, on this. Get the level 6 first. Oh, I guess you can't. Dang. Yeah, even the fact that you didn't push her out of lane early and she just got the TP on a wave that actually ended up working out for her, she got 6 before you even in this matchup. You know what I mean? Like, that's not good. When you know that she's going to W because she already used her jump, like, I don't know why you're running as if she still has jumps, right? You can just stay on her. Like, you can play here, and then when you, because you know she's going to come out of this side of the W, then you can just pop it over onto her.
Right.
Chase a little bit, get another Q, and then back out.
I think I went back in like a weird amount of gold. I just bought Negatron. Is that like really bad in this matchup?
I mean, the double Doran's Negatron here are just going to mean you're not going to die. Like, if you're actually playing, you know, the champ and the matchup to the your full potential, then I would say it is bad. But because she just hit 6 without a deficit, this is fine. Because you're not going to die and you're going to be able to bully her still now. Because just by the numbers, you're going to be able to beat her. And with your range, you know what I mean? Like, with 40 MR on a 720 buy, that's just crazy. I don't know about that. You could get a free... Yeah, that's bad. That's really bad. You should push the wave so that you get the free gold as so as it is and not have to risk making it down there in time, especially when they look like they're about to go out. If you wanted to be really cheeky, I think you could have potentially went for that. And
the Graves.
Killed the Graves, yeah. It was actually possible for sure to kill him. It's just more so about, like, do you want to risk... Actually, I guess if... No, because there's no way Lucian still had his heal after that. So, yeah, he would have definitely died. It's just like, do you want to save the ult for here so that you're not stagnated in lane and she can just go on you because she knows you don't have it? Or do you want to kill him? And I think there, actually, the decision is to kill him. So you should have went for that. You understand how you would have been able to, right? You literally just QW R on him, R... And then he's pretty much dead. Alright, so Fiora's getting shoved in by Jason, you see that? And she's behind in the matchup. So your next thought should be, I could actually gank top, right? Because if she's under tower and she's low, it doesn't matter that there's a tower there. You and Jace can burst her easy. You can bait out her Q very or her W very easily and then just kill her, and if she never uses it, then you guys just kill her. Does that make sense?
Yeah, it would have been pretty easy.
Move up.
Because I saw like the Graves on the map.
No, that's fine. Your Lee has control of the right side. Oh, Jesus. Whoa. Oh, no.
I don't think I should have flashed that pressure. I was just dead, like, anyway. Okay, gets the fat stacks here.
I'll get back to it, dude. I'm just taking my time. I feel like I just watched a horror movie, dude. My heart, it needs a break. And you know, all that greasy American food that we eat as well is not very good for our heart. So anytime anything goes off like this, we just need a break, dude. Whew, goodness. All right, let's go back to that and break it down. Okay, so you also should have used your ball beforehand so that you have the extra one on the, you know what I mean? Like, I don't think it's as important to stun him here because he's not going to kill the Graves at that time. So you should use your Q instead of your E there on Graves and then ult him. It'll give you way more damage. Because you have. Actually, you have enough for both. No, you don't. Not an ult. Never mind. Okay. So yeah, Q instead of E. That's what I. That's the only thing there. Because if you Q'd instead of E'd, you actually would have killed him. Right?
Think so?
I think so. Do you want to do the math on that right now?
We can if you want.
We could. Yeah, dude, four, I don't even need to do the math. 100%. Four levels of Q versus one level of E, and the fact that it adds a ball to the ultimate.
Well, yeah.
Yeah, definitely. He had 320 HP. And he has how much MR? 52? The efficiency freak in me needs to see this. You know what I mean? Like, it's not, it shouldn't be that important. Also, the thing is, this guy shouldn't even be this low because all he had to do was ward. He has it because he ends up putting it down. But like 3 hours too late.
I think he was just going for
Oh,
like
never
some
mind.
flashy play, some the flashy Lee Sin play.
Yeah, but oof. Also, doesn't he know that E literally gives you vision?
Maybe he used it, maybe not.
Yeah. Anyway. Okay, yeah, so I think that's how you could have comboed better there. It should have been cleaner from him too. You guys should have been able to kill him and at least one of you get out, but thankfully Jace gets something out of it. And it's not just plus, bot lane got something, so it's like 3 for 3 overall. It's okay for your team, but it just sucks for you guys there, yeah. You can go that. If you have double Doran's and the Forbidden Chapter, I think you really need to be on point in making sure that your wave is pretty much always shoved mid. Okay?
Yeah, I'd have insane mana with that shit. Maybe if I
I
saved my
do
E, I
like
could have
this
killed that
combo.
Lucian. Actually, no, I'm out, so killed him, you know what I mean?
No, you don't have ult. He was full HP, right?
Yeah.
So, yeah. That's just. Like, I'm not even gonna really go into that because Lee Sin just made an awful play there and you were just trying to salvage it. There's nothing really more. Okay. That's good. No! Save your E! Or your Q. Or, yeah, no. Your E for your Q there. And then after you do that, walk away. I think you might have been able to still live even after that misplay. So, yeah. Oof, man. Yeah, definitely save the Q there. And then. Yeah, save E, and let's see if you can live here. Yeah, because look, she had to wind up for another attack. So if you had this primed first, so your mouse should be here first, click away, and then switch instantly back QR as soon as she comes back. Like, right when she's here about to ult back on you, that's when you want to click back, and then as soon as she goes onto you, then you QR, keep walking back, and then I think she doesn't get the auto off to kill you. But anyway, yeah, the first misplay came from not saving your E for when your Q was up. You can sell... potion for the biscuit boots. For boots. Yeah. I guess since you don't have too much AP right now because of like the low CS and how you played early lane, you can keep the Dorns instead of selling it for the pink. But you're gonna have to towards mid game sell Dorns for pink if you don't have slots. Since she didn't go Negatron, you should be going Morello here, by the way.
Yeah, I'd pressure, I'd just go straight for it.
Alright.
Close.
Huh. You tanked that to the mouth and just said, my runes and masteries got me, boys. I believe in them. Yeah, again, that's just Lee Sin. Like, I don't understand what his thought process is on a lot of these plays. Honestly, would have much rather you had, like, a... fucking Master Yi, even just sitting in the jungle farming the entire game, coming out at 20 minutes and actually doing something, than like wasting all this time early game. Thankfully, Graves isn't doing too hot either, but alright, you should move up first. He wants you to do this so he can get the farm, dude. That's why he's... A lot of assassins will do this, and mid laners in general should. Like, get out of vision between each wave. And now you can even stun him, and you're just not. You have to believe in your ability to 100 to 0 him, because you definitely can, right here. Right?
Yeah.
So, you don't have to save the E for if he goes on you there. That's the only reason that you didn't go on him there is because you thought you would have to save your E. And on top of that, if he does try to go in and you think maybe he's going to be able to burst you even through the Negatron somehow, you still have exhaust. And you have him trapped, like, on top of you, and you just get the kill. He can't even flash out. Right?
Yeah, it would have been pretty easy. I don't know, because she was, like, quite fed as well. She's, like, 4-2. I wanted to be a bit...
Nah, that doesn't mean anything. Even the level that she has up on you doesn't mean anything relative to the fact that she has barely any MR for the amount of AP that you have. Even if you don't, like, 100 to 0 her off the first combo, you can honestly just follow her down the lane and either make her use Flash or kill her. Probably kill her, honestly. Me see what you were doing there. Wait, is this too far back? Yeah, I guess it was.
Yeah.
It was way too far back. Wait. No, you could have killed the Lucian, dude. No, they don't need your help with Thresh. As soon as this guy moved back up. Yeah, and he E'd. You saw him E. If you took this path instead of this path, you can QE him
just...
here and kill him. You see that? Don't go for the free kill participation just because it's there, you know what I mean? And it's only 75 gold anyway. And you're still going to get the experience from being around. But you could get the extra kill on Lucian. Guarantee that you take this tower. And then, yeah, have the extra gold and everything from that experience. Fucking champion. See? Nice once again. At least you know yourself, dude. Dirty Syndra picker. Stop.
I should have
upped. I'll type. Yep.
Yeah, I actually could have bought Penguin there, but I was too busy.
It's when you tell that guy in all chat he's getting outlaned by a Vayne who has a Dota club name. But the most tilting part about that is he's not even getting outlaned. Their deaths are only to you and Lee Sin, ganks. But then he just gets even more frustrated about it. And then he starts flaming his jungler because he's like, you were never around. You made me look bad. That's what you do to low ego players. All right. Yeah, you definitely did not keep at the edge of your ranges there, 100%. You did not have to get this close to her at any point in time. Guaranteed she's, like, granted, not guaranteed, she slid into you. But this is very expected. Like, you have to know that she's going to go from here to here. So, your path can't be here, it has to be, you sit here, play around the, like, edge of your range, wait for her to waste this Q, and then keep... You know, like, stay at the edge, go back if you need to. Like, you can even exhaust her there to set up your W. And then you still have that kill, and you get out. Because then you walk out that way, to the left. And if Akali tries to follow you this way, your ult's going to be up. Right?
Mm-hmm. And Akali just getting huge, but
yeah. But see how the top play even plays into that? Because if you wasted her time longer, she wouldn't have even been able to make it on time to engage in that whole fiasco, right?
Yeah.
That's like how when people are like, oh man, I won my lane, but I don't know what more I could have done. Like, literally every little thing, every decision that you make has an impact on the game elsewhere too, you know what I mean? Even that little thing up there actually could have led to Akali not getting three kills or whatever she just got down there. Right?
Should I have stole that farm from the Vayne or keep it? Or
Nah,
like
let her
give
take
it
it.
to
She was doing fine anyway, and you got farm coming mid. Plus, yeah, 4-2-1, and you play on EUS, so there's always that like hidden passive
she
where
really
if
just
you
went
steal, yeah,
AFK.
exactly, you steal CS from an AD carry and it's just gone. They'll tell you some things about different races that you don't even have in your blood. And all right. You could have taken that melee. It's a free 21 gold, my man. All right. Kill her. Wait, did you E right after you Q'd against Fia?
I think so.
You shouldn't have. You should have Q and then you like you Q on top of her, W, walk away a little bit, hold. If she uses W, then you just W her after and then E. Or then like she chases you, doesn't use W, and just dies to the guys chasing her and your Q. You know what I mean? Like, you didn't have to use your ultimate there. Do you want me to go back over it, or do you understand?
Yeah, I know what you mean now.
Okay. Salvadorans. Oh no! The Kermit the Frog meme, dude. It's like me, Salvadorans, buy a pink ward. Inner me, don't do it. Just buy the blasting one.
Want an extra like 10 AP.
Ugh. Oh, you can get him there. Do you know the EQ trick or no?
It's like a almost like instant stun
Yeah, it's
thing.
instant stun, and it even adds a little bit of range to if you can get it at the very, very tip, I think. Or I don't think it adds range, but yeah, never mind. It doesn't add range, but it's gonna be unexpected, and that was at the range where it would have hit him. Does that make sense? You also could have exhausted.
And he wouldn't have killed me, and I could have killed
Yep. But there was a lot you did wrong there. You know what I mean? Like you should have
if I
been
just
walking.
landed the stun, like at the
Yeah.
start.
First thing is landing stun. Or just, no, actually, you should save it. You know, there was a study done recently, like an actual scientific study with a thesis and everything, I'm pretty sure. And players in Challenger use their abilities way less. You know why? Because a Thresh that holds his Q, or a Syndra that holds her QE,
They get
still
more
have that
pressure.
threat. Yeah, exactly. You can force his hand without using your QE. He just knows that it exists. And in D5 especially, actually, what I've noticed is a lot of players have an over-exaggerated fear of a lot of different cooldowns even, because, you know, like, or they'll even see the cooldown used and think that it's going to be, like, up quicker than it actually is. You know what I mean? But in this scenario, that's not even important. Like, he just is respecting your QE anyway. That's why he held his dash, right? So if you have his mental timer going and he's like you're just mind gaming him, he can either think, oh, maybe she already used her QE and then uses E aggressively, or you just wait and see where he's gonna be moving towards and then use your E toward like your QE towards wherever he's gonna end up dodging because he already showed his hand and already clicked there, you know what I mean? So yeah, and plus if like going perpendicular, like you were here and he was down there. So let's say, I mean, obviously, hold on, we can even. Oh, you don't scroll your camera to there. All right, let's say you were like here and he was on an edge like this, where he can play this side and this side. It's better if you're on the same level as him, you know what I mean? In that regard, when he has a Thresh there, so that you can both dodge the Thresh this way and this way, instead of having to think about two different like vertices when you're trying to hit your skill shot and dodge. And like then at that point you have to have pretty much script or mouse movements to dodge and hit your QE. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So, yeah, you were at a really bad angle to combat like someone with a dash and their support. No. You wasted it. Ruined. You should have exhausted her there for sure. She was gonna burst him no matter what once she got into the range to do so. But if you exhausted, you would have saved them. And then you guys have 5v3, which is potential for an Asher, especially with a Vayne. What are you going for next with that blasting wand?
Void staff, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, it is.
Why? Who do they
Quite a
have?
few of them had their if I press damn, I really don't press grab.
Yeah, you should do that more often. It was just Graves. Pretty sure. All right. From now on, every time during every session when you press tab, I'm gonna sneeze because you act like you're allergic to the tab. You open it and then you just get rid of it as soon as possible. I'm about to. Oh my god, I'm gonna have to slow-mo this, dude. I'm gonna have to slow-mo it. Please. Wait, I went forward. Okay. No! I'm gonna get this, dude. Jesus.
No. Wow.
Okay.
10th time lucky.
I'm slow-moing it, dude. I need to see what your best bet for your build is. All right, boys. Yeah, you should definitely go something other than Void. I think it's gonna be the Andres. Actually, they don't. No, you should do Rabadons first. Yeah, you can do Rabadons, and then if they don't get any more MR than this,
Can get like Leandries or some
you can
shit.
get Leandres. If they get more MR than this, then you go Void Staff. Does that make sense? Yep. All right. Here we go.
Normal speed now.
Hell yeah, dude. Is it? Yeah, it is. Okay. What is this lag?
I think it was an FPS drop.
Okay, so it wasn't on me. Okay. You should chase that guy.
The ballsy threshes.
Hmm?
The ballsy threshes. They're always
Yeah.
like they have like no fear.
Yeah, no, you definitely could have chased him. He didn't have his cooldowns, he wasn't gonna lock you down even if Lucian showed up. You know what I mean? You could have just burst him. Like, it's a worth risk to take. It's a worth risk on your flash if you absolutely end up having to live. That's somewhere where that's actually a worth investment. Because that's way more than just a 60-40. You know what I mean? Like,
Yeah.
if you end up killing him, then it's really, really good. And it's not that likely that he actually has someone near him. Because they would have already shown up to the fight. And because Akali had already been seen splitting bot. So you can actually go for the thresh there. All right. So, what do you know about Lucian or about their team right now based on just what Lucian did here? I want you to tell me. Read Lucian and tell me what is true
There's
about.
people behind them.
No, there's
Whoa.
no one behind him.
You
Because if
think
there was
so?
anyone behind him, his movement would have been up here or he would have started autoing the Lee Sin and then backed off with respect to you after that. But because there's no one behind him, he started moving away right away and just left the Thresh to die. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Like a book, dude. They're so easy to read.
I just saw him just run like in a straight lane right towards me, then can I just change?
Yeah, exactly. But the thing is, that tells you a lot. It's just like you're thinking that he's running two people. He's not running two people. If he had people behind him, they know that they're gonna catch up and he's gonna, or he knows that they're gonna catch up and be able to join the fight, so he's gonna try to get damage down and start stacking his fur before the fight starts. And then if he forces you to like Q him and dashes out, then that's good for him because he can keep hitting Lee.
Maybe I should have stayed to help that Vel'Koz. Maybe.
Nah, dude, it's too risky. 'Cause if you end up getting trapped there, just sitting around when all you see is a Kali, so you don't know where the rest, like the rest of our team is definitely coming, then you don't wanna stick around with him. It's too dangerous.
I went a pistol here because
What?
the calories are
Stay at the edge
different.
of the inside of the circle so you have your home guards. You just didn't take home guards.
I thought they'd glitched. Like, I swear, I thought they just didn't work.
It's just, it only works on the inside of the circle. No, you should wait there and then EQ the Thresh. And then if Lucian walks away after you EQ Thresh, then you go in and kill him. But if Lucian moves up or stays where he is, then you back off. Because again, you can read him. When you find a player that's really easy to read based on like what his team does, you just wanna do that every single time they have Fog of War behind them. Like everything he did told you that it was only him and Thresh top. Flash and alt Graves there. Or QE, I guess, because the ult wouldn't be in range, and then you ult him. Like, Akali's not ever with her team flanking, so you don't have to worry about someone coming in behind you. You can definitely flash. Yeah, I don't like this build. Like, Akali isn't even doing anything to you, you know what I mean? You shouldn't have finished Abyssal. I guess you don't do that as much for the MR when you finish Abyssal as you do for the CDR and the damage, but you were better off going Rabadons and then like more damage after either Leandres or Void instead, because then you guarantee you can 100-0 anyone whenever you want by yourself. And so you have that threat over just having to play with your team that you can flank or take a couple different positions to want to 100-0 literally any member of their team if they get out of position. Like, it doesn't matter who it is, doesn't matter how much MR they have. If you did that, then you would have been able to kill them. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Well, when you go Void Abyssal, you don't know if you have exactly enough AP to kill someone that has MR and HP. Like, if they have HP, then they're the bane of your existence.
Yeah, I think if my build was better, it made quite a lot of difference in this game. They have one mountain and Vayne's like they can one shot bomb.
With the earth, yeah. They would finish it pretty quick. Now, with two of them, that would be scary as fuck. If you take your eye off Nashor, it's disappearing. Ooh, that was really. Yeah, you shouldn't be going there because Lee Sin can go there since he has his dash, but here you want to be going through the areas that are warded. You don't know if anyone's coming from here because there's Fog of War. You do know that no one is coming from here because you have wards. Like, you have this pink that would have seen anyone coming from here, so you could just walk out this way, right? Instead of walking here and then having to blow flash for no reason. So that's more of like an autopilot thing. Just didn't really consider which way you were going to be going. Right, that's good. They should back out. Nah, yeah, they shouldn't be going for her. Oh my god. Their guys are just not on the same page. All right. You don't want to be. Okay. So when Fiora comes, you don't want to be here. And Graves, especially, too. You don't want to be here when they show up because you're not playing at the edge of your range, okay? If you had the whole team there, including Vayne, you have the option of potentially walking into here, so you still have the maximum degree of separation that you can and play on your range instead of hers. That's one thing you're gonna have to start respecting more, right? Like, that's if there's nothing else you get out of this session, it's that you have to play around your ranges. Even though there's a lot. Like, there's a lot that we went over. But so don't trap yourself on this wall and keep the distance that you can, but when you're here and she's here, you already are losing, right? Not just psychologically, but literally in the game. Like, this is a big mistake against these two champions. So against them, you'd rather be either in the Baron Pit if you have the whole team, but you have Vayne in base. So you would be more so here. Like, he can tank this by himself because you guys are still kind of around, and you can weave in and out with your Q. You're not going to really be doing much damage with your autos anyway. So you weave in and out with your Q, maybe W it if they're not really pushing past, so and you save your E, and then if they come close, then you just hit them with your combo. Does that make sense? And that changes this. Like, that changes all of that. It's a definite win for you that way. Is the FPS dropping because you're alt tabbing?
I
Yes, it is.
think, yeah.
Yeah, don't do that. If you're serious about improving, you shouldn't alt tab really much at all. Like, you can get so much info out of what they use, especially if the fight's still going on, instead of like alt tabbing when you're about to die. Or when you do die. Stay on the bottom side of the. Wait, where did she go?
She must have just run.
What? Oh, I guess it was on the very edge of the fog of war. And so you didn't see her leave. Because we didn't see her, right? Or was that your camera?
Yeah, no, like
I guess you just,
she
yeah,
just.
lucked out with the edge of the fog of war. But that's why it's even more important for you to be a little closer to the bottom of that, to cut her off.
I think it's just like super risky fighting here. They are low though.
Yeah, it would have been better for you guys to just push your lanes out. There's no need to do this when the lanes are shoving.
Just the instant surrender move.
Yeah, dude, that's what I'm talking about. If earlier in the game you would have taxed that wave, it would have come way earlier. Nah, this is pretty big for them here. You gotta commit. Like, you have to commit to one or the other. Here, it's honestly probably Lucian. It's probably just using both of your summoners on him, killing him, and then going top. That's your best bet there. Take the AD carry out and then stop them from taking the Nexus towers. But yeah. Do you have any questions?
None really. Just gonna
Yeah.
try and play Syndra's ranges more.
Yeah, for sure. There's a lot in here micro-wise, like it's probably one of the most micro-intensive sessions that I've done in a while, you know what I mean? So, because there was a lot, like Syndra, and in this Elo too, and then like reading people in her ranges is really important. So, yeah, I'm glad this was a good session. So I'll upload it, and then you should go over it, take notes, and then yeah, play around those
Yeah,
ranges,
well.
my man. All right, thank you for the session.
Yeah.
Talk soon.